This video will take you from Excel Shortcuts Beginner to Excel Shortcuts Pro. And for this, we'll put the shortcuts in tiers from Rookie Level all the way to Sensei Level using Formula One themes as analogies so you don't get bored. Let's go. Starting off at the Rookie Level and in F1 equivalents, that would have to be Williams and Haas. Sorry if there's any fans out there. So let's take a look at the Excel file, which you can download in the description. We've got this large data set over here, and don't worry too much about the content itself. If you want to navigate across it, you can obviously use the down arrow, but that's obviously going to take quite a bit of time. Instead, you can use the control up arrow to get all the way to the top, control down arrow to get all the way to the top. If you press the down arrow again, that takes you to the very bottom of the Excel file, control up arrow again, and then right and left to go across. Similarly, if you actually want to select an area, you can press the control and shift, and then from there go down arrow all the way to the bottom, that would take you, and then control shift right arrow, that would take you all the way to the end. Now suppose we don't really want the very last column. For that, you can press the shift and then the left arrow. That's gonna allow you to do that, the right arrow to select it again. And same thing if you go shift up or shift down, that allows you to select whatever area you want. Moving on to manipulating the data, so things like adding rows or adding columns. For that, let's suppose we wanna add a new row here. To select it, you can obviously just click it here if you want, but the shortcut for that is actually just going to shift space. That's gonna select the row for you. And then to add a row, you can press control shift plus, control shift plus again to add, and then control minus, that would be to delete some. Similarly for the columns, it's control space instead of shift space there. And then you can press the control shift plus to add some, and then control minus to delete some there as well. Press control Z if you wanna go back if you deleted too many like me. Now suppose we do want to add a few more rows, and for this area here under Northeast and New York on these, we just want the same thing for all the other ones. You can obviously just press control C and control V to paste it, but an actual faster way to do that is just by pressing control D, control D again. So what that does, it basically pastes anything that you had above. So as you can see, that's working there. Similarly, if you want to copy whatever you had to the left, you can press control R, so basically taking you to the right. And lastly, under the Rookie Level, if you want to navigate across workbooks, you can press the control page down. That's going to take you to the next tab, and control page up to go back up. That's the Rookie Level, and now moving on to the Amateur Level, so those that use Excel occasionally. In F1 equivalents, that would have to be Alfa Tauri, Alfa Romeo, and Aston Martin. Let's say we're given this small table over here, and first up we have the invoice date, which as you can see is in this odd format because it's obviously not in a date there. Now, if you want to change that, we would first select it by control shift and down arrow all the way to the bottom there, and now press control 1. That's going to open up this whole dialog box where basically you can change the type of format that you want. In our case, let's say we wanted a specific date, and within that you can change a ton of different formats. Let's say we're okay with the first one. And similar to that, you do have different tabs where you can control different things about that cell. Hit okay there for now. Now you can see it's all changed to the date format. There is a quicker way to go about this. First, press control Z. That's going to take you back to how it was originally. And now you want to press the control shift and number. That's going to put you to a date format quickly. Then looking at the other data in the table, as you can see for the price per unit, let's suppose we want this one to have a dollar sign as its price after all. So control shift down. And here you want to press the control shift dollar sign, which is fairly intuitive there. Similarly for the unit sold, we do want to have some commas in there. For that, we gotta make it a number, so go to control shift 1, and that's gonna do it for us. And lastly, for the operating margin, we'd like it to be in percentage. So again, control shift down to select it, and then control shift percentage sign. Another great tool here is a paste special feature. You can see over here, we've got a different table. And now let's suppose we want the same format as this one over here. Now, were we to just copy and paste the whole table, then obviously all the numbers would change as well, which isn't quite what we want. Instead, we can select it by pressing control A, then control C. And instead of just pasting by pressing control V, what we want to do here is actually go to paste special, which you can press control alt V for that. And here you can see you have a ton of different paste options. So for instance, you can only paste the formulas, the values itself without the formatting, etc., etc. In our case, let's say we just want the formats, and then hit okay there. And now you can see that everything's changed to this exact same format, but the values remained what they were originally. Alright, now we're on to the higher tiers, and we'll put Alpine and McLaren in here. And here's the table that we'll be working with, and as you can see, this one requires a lot more work than the previous ones. And for this, we'll be using the Alt key. As you can see, if you press the Alt key once, a ton of different numbers and letters start to pop up. This is basically to replace the mouse. First up here, let's go ahead and auto-fit these columns. As you can tell, they're not very consistent and you can go one by one, which is very tedious. Instead, we're gonna press the Ctrl A, and then from there, we're gonna go to Alt, go to the homepage, H, O, is gonna go under format, and we wanna go to the I, which is the auto-fit column width here. Press I there. Similarly for the rows, we can go to Alt, H, O, A in this case, and that's gonna auto-fit the rows as well. And just like that, using a few keystrokes, it's looking a lot more like it. Let's finish it up. Firstly, let's remove the grid lines, which is basically this grayish line color that we've got. Go to Alt W V G there, so it's a lot less distracting. And let's work on this data set a bit. As you can see, the price per unit doesn't actually have decimals. It'd probably be useful to do so. So we'll go Control Shift down and then press the Alt H 0. That's gonna add a decimal. Alt H 0 again if you wanna add another one. And then Alt H 9, that's gonna remove a decimal for us. Let's also highlight this top part over here. So we'll go Control Shift and right arrow. Control B is gonna bolden it for us. And let's add a border of sorts. So we can go to Alt H B. From here, you'll be able to select whatever border you want. Let's just go with a simple O, which is the bottom border. Now that's looking more like it. And suppose we're looking through a data set and we find a number that we find a bit suspicious. Like say this first one, we don't think it's quite right, the price per unit. If you want to leave a comment on it, say for your analyst or something, you can just press the Shift F2 key. That's going to open up the panel. And then here you can write whatever you want, like hello, say. Now when I get out of it, it'll remain as this red dot, which you can hover over it and there's going to be a clear sign there. If you're not done with this data set and you want to add a few more beverage brands from above, you can just go towards this very bottom one and then press the Alt down arrow. Now you can see that you're going to get all of these suggested ones, which are basically all of the ones that we had above. Let's say I go with Coca-Cola here. Same thing applies to say New York. Go to Alt down arrow and now I can select New York from that list. Lastly, we've got the Excel senseis. So those that spent years trying to master these shortcuts.
You must feel the force around you.
And in here, we're gonna put Red Bull, Mercedes, Ferrari, and of course, Fernando Alonso. And at this level, they don't just use regular keyboard shortcuts. Instead, they customize them using the quick access toolbar. So let me show you how to go about that. That should be on the top left-hand side that you can see over here, and yours is probably gonna look different to mine, as mine is already customized. If you wanna get inside it, you can go under File, go to Options, and from here, go to the Quick Access Toolbar. So over on the right-hand side are all of the Quick Access Toolbar tools that I currently have, whilst on the left are all of the commands available. Go to All Commands so you can find all of them. From here, feel free to copy all of these in the same order. So suppose I find the camera just by typing camera in here, then I'll just go to add and I'll be able to add it. If you ever want to change the order, go to up or down arrow. The order is going to matter as that's gonna change the shortcut you have to type in it. So once you're happy with what you've got, press the OK key there. And now over here, let's go ahead and reformat this using the quick access toolbar. You can find it on the top left hand side. If you want to drag it down a bit, you can just put it to show below ribbon and it's gonna be down over here. So first things first, let's auto-fit this column. So Control Space. And now all we need to press is the Alt 6. And that's gonna do it for us. Before we had to do the Alt HOI, which is a lot more tedious, obviously. Then let's highlight the top row in dark blue. So go to Control Shift Right. And from here, we're gonna go to Alt 5. And let's go ahead and with the arrow keys, just go to the dark blue like so. We'll also change the font color to a white so we can see it a bit better. For this, go to Alt 4. And now let's change that to a white. Press Ctrl B to bolden. And just below, we'll do the same thing, but actually put it in light blue. So we'll go to Alt 5 and we'll select the light blue, kind of like so. Great, now let's separate the total revenue a bit more. So let's go select it, Ctrl Shift Right, and then we're just gonna go to Alt 3, and then let's press C, so it's quite clear, Ctrl B to bolden that. Now you can see what that's currently looking like. And if you're feeling a bit lazy and even these shortcuts aren't quite enough for you, you can go ahead and select the whole table by pressing Ctrl A. Then you're just gonna go to Alt 2. That's gonna give you the auto-formatted tables. So basically Excel suggests a few different table formats for you. Let's say we go for the classic number 2, hit OK. And just like that, that's gonna be edited to their standards. And one last really cool trick is the camera tool. So let's go ahead and select this table, Control A. Now we're just gonna press the Alt 1 to take a screenshot of it. Let's say we paste it right over here. So just click there once. Now you can see we have the exact same table. You might be wondering, well, that's just a normal image. What's so cool about that? And the difference here is that suppose I change this number to a 5. Now this one over here is also dynamically going to change. So suppose we have this, say, in the summary tab or something, and we're able to make changes over here, and they're gonna be reflected down over here as well, which is what's really cool about it. So is my Formula One rating of Excel shortcuts accurate? Let me know in the comments down below. If you wanna learn more about the quick access toolbar, check out this link over here. And if you wanna learn more about Excel, specifically for a job in business or finance, check out this link over here, where we teach everything we know about Excel, specifically applied to the workforce. Hit that like and that subscribe button if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.